Alright, so today we're going to be building a fully suspensioned two-speed off-road go-kart. Now, we're going to be using a 420cc Predator engine. I'm finally starting to invest in some of the bigger Predator engines that they make. We're also going to be using this stuff from Go Power Sports. These are 22-inch rear tires, 20-inch front tires, a 40-series torque converter, and the shocks, the sprocket, the disc brake, and the axle, all from Go Power Sports. We're also going to be using one of my two-speed transmissions. Now, this is the third two-speed transmission I've ever made, and we're going to be using it on this project. So yeah, let's get started. Oh, it's big. Ooh, it's heavy. Oh, man. Yeah, this is a lot bigger and a lot heavier than the 212s. Alright, so after looking at, you know, the size of this engine and the size of this torque converter, and then looking at my two-speed transmission, you know, comparing the two, I'm pretty sure that this may not be able to withstand the kind of torque that this engine produces, mainly because this has a three-quarter axle. Now, it may work, it may be fine, but I don't want to, you know, have to be cautious with this thing. I don't want to have to be worrying that this is gonna break. So what I'm probably gonna do is I'm probably just gonna save this one, use it for a different project, and then make a new one using a 1-inch axle. Therefore, that's gonna make it to where I need to use bigger bearings, bigger bushings, bigger sprockets, just bigger everything, but it will be able to withstand the kind of torque this engine produces. You know, save this one, use it for a different project, but make a new one, a much bigger one. So yeah, now what I really want to do is, you know, lay this stuff out on the floor and figure out how big the frame's going to be and how big all this stuff, and just figure out the layout of this go-kart. Alright, so I'm thinking this is a good size for how big I want it to be. It's, you know, plenty big. I have plenty of, you know, room for my feet if I do the front suspension correctly. And yes, I am going to be putting the engine over the rear axle. It's going to allow it to be a little bit smaller frame. Also, it may even allow this go-kart to do wheelies. That would be really cool. That's Now I think this is a good size for, you know, what I want. You know, it's plenty small enough to where it'll fit everything that I want to do to this go-kart. And so yeah, I think this is a good size. Let me start working on the frame. So yeah, we got a lot of work done considering this is part one of this project. Now, I know it really doesn't look like we got much work done, but mainly this stuff right now is just figuring out how it's all gonna go together, how it's all gonna work together and stuff like that. And also I've been, you know, spending a lot of time at the lathe turning these pivot points. Now, honestly, this frame kind of turned out a lot bigger than I originally was planning on making this. I mean, I kind of wanted it to be, you know, have big tires, big engine, but I wanted to make it as compact as possible, and that really did not turn out. I mean, this thing is almost the same size as the dune buggy, and that's really not the end of the world, but for now, I'm kind of really running out of room to put all this stuff, so I'm gonna have to figure out a way to... I'm gonna have to figure out where I'm gonna put this thing for, you know, in the meantime as I'm building it. It's also making it really hard to work on other stuff. I've been wanting to, you know, start painting the mini green ATV, but I can't really pull it out and work on it because, you know, this is taking up all my workspace. But now I know what you guys are thinking. You want me to take the Honda CBR and put it in this frame, and honestly, I was kind of thinking about doing that until I remembered that the Honda's not running right now. It's not running. I'm not really sure what it's going to take to get running, so I'm just going to be using the 420 for now. And now I know, now I've never really played around with a 420s before, so I'm not really sure what kind of power it produces. I'm really hoping that it has enough power to move a go-kart of this size. I'm trying to make the frame as lightweight as possible, so you know, to try and make sure that it's not a problem. But remember, we are putting a two-speed transmission on this frame, and I still need to make the two-speed transmission. I'm probably gonna make a separate video about making that. And if I gear the two-speed transmission correctly, it should have plenty of power in first gear and plenty of speed in second gear. So I have to thank GoPower Sports for sending me all these parts that I've been using in this video. I will be leaving links in the description below to all the parts I've been using in this video. Go check that out. And yeah, I think this video is long enough, so I'm gonna have to end the video here. Thank you for watching, subscribe, and have a nice day.